San Francisco. You can scan it, the code, and it'll take you to my YouTube channel. With some popcorn ready, it's 4 hours.
Hello everyone, just checking the cameras.
So it's like, with me it's like, I want to get back as far as I can, but I want to stay as close as I can. So, if I turn into a, this is what it is. So. That was my first one. Okay. So now something is starting to. Something is starting to happen. So now we've got the background with ours, the panels. This is a little bit warmer. I'm gonna, let's see. Lighten up a tad bit. So.
Hello.
How are you?
It. It.
Let's shout over your quick hug.
Yes,
good
to see you.
Cool. Welcome. This is my
face.
This is my partners in crime. We're gonna rob some restaurants. So yes, now advise you, feel free to, the only thing I ask is just be mindful of these cameras here that don't go between there. Or she's gonna disappear into some other parallel universe. But feel free to walk around. So you can come around here if you like, if that gives you a better view. So, yeah, I'm just painting the bongo drums.
Oh, okay.
And we're live. So let me go back to this. At least for me, as much as I attempt, I want to be in the moment. I want to be in the fresh moment of pain. So that's why I'm kind of moving so quickly at times. I'm gonna get to the drums in a moment. Don't worry, I'm missing just as much as you are. So I just want to hit some certain areas that help push and pull it. So. Check the cameras again. For some reason, that one went off. Oh, it's still recording. Okay. What's happened here? Cool. Okay, let's go to, let's see. Now we're gonna go to the drums. And as everyone can see, you can kind of get an idea of the value in the light or dark and just the color, of the board, the background. So I'm just gonna wipe this excess paint off. Then try and clean a little bit more off with the thinner, and then with this shirt.
like my, you know, my fable, like, brush cloth. It's actually, for those of you that are aware, Theo Puente.
Hey.
Oh, yeah.
April 20th, 1923 to May 31st, 2000. So, mm-hmm. I was wearing that shirt at the Puerto Rican Day Parade. Okay, so. So once again with the red, that's where I got the red. With the, let's see, the red, I'm trying to get a medium tone here. Okay, folks, we got a good hour left. And so right now with the red, not too much going on other than the alizarin and the cad red. So I'm just going to quickly go through. And the actual bars, I'll paint that in later. So. This is actually the first time I've done this at, painted live at one of my exhibitions. So it's interesting because it is a challenge, I admit. Because everyone's like right here. But I also used to sketch and paint in Times Square. So this is, they each have their own challenge. As you can see, that portion of right here is a little bit further left, and it's a little bit further right, so I'm going to get the gray. Now, the other night I was like doing like a pre-sketch just to try and get my chops loose on it. So I just got to correct a few drawing things, but I'm trying to get the color as quickly as possible. Hello? And my friend, Gonzalo, if you're watching, or any friend of Gonzalo, who's also chef, if you're watching, my friend gave me these drums. But I thought they would be cool to paint because I like red and black, you know. And that's also the color of my website. So I'm not too good at paint red at all. So now it's going to, and we'll be here. You promise. So now I'm just going to go into the dark of the this portion of the drums, and we'll go back to the black. And as you can see, I mean, obviously I'm still covering the large areas, but I'm still using the big brush, so.
Does it take to work on portraits?
They can be anywhere from like 7 to 10 hours.
Not start to finish.
Yeah.
Really?
Mm-hmm. I should paint at the next exhibit, you know, to. I do have like an innate passion just to try and evolve as a painter, to try and quote unquote get better. So the challenge, I'll take a challenge on painting someone like at the next exhibit. Some of the proportions are a little bit off, but we'll fix it as much as we can at the time being. Yeah.
When you're doing your dance and engagements, do you always take your painting material with you?
Sorry?
When you do your dancing,
No.
You take the four paints?
Probably the most I've done is I've taken my sketchbook.
Do the sketchbook?
Yeah.
Did you have trouble bringing that on the airplane or through the baggage through the airplane?
I've done that, I did that for Niagara Falls.
Yeah.
That was 2 years ago. I was in Canada for 4th of July on that Tuesday. And yeah, it was just, I had to carry this, I think I had 2 carry-on items or something like that, and everything else I had to pack up. But yeah, you just have to think ahead a little more when you're packing, you know, so.
You can't carry solvents, right? The solvents.
Yeah, you have to like, you know, put it in the bag and if it's in my suitcase or if it's in a separate bag, you have to check it, you know. I had to do that coming back when I was leaving JFK. So it was a lot of stuff going on, so I didn't have like to buy a bag and sort of zip it up and something else, you know, so. But it is what it is. So. All right. Okay, so let's get to off-white. So, gotta move quicker. I feel like I have to move quicker just to like keep the immediacy going. So we're gonna make the top of the drawings. The ideal situation you want to make a mark with that right exact color, that exact shape. But that's easier said than done. Much easier said than done. So. Now I should probably go with a smaller brush. So at least for now, I think I've done enough with the beginning area of using the big brush. So I'm just going to go take a smaller brush and I'm going to. Are you able to, if you want, is there enough space over there for you?
You can stand in front of me. It's cool. I can hold your shoulders. No problem.
That's like a kennel of color.
Would you like to add this to your paper?
Look at it. Shadow under the drums.
starting to do something. It's starting to do a little something. So right now, little by little, it's starting to ground itself. All I need to work out the fine shape of the board. It's looking a little as refined. That was that's on my YouTube channel.
Yeah, I just saw that. Yeah. You can actually watch this one then, huh? Do you do it like a fast thing, or is it you actually?
No, it's
in its full like.
Yeah, it's like that one's like maybe 3.5, maybe under 4 hours.
Oh my goodness.
The San Francisco Bridge, I think I lost some clips of it because I was going from one camera to the other, trying to recharge something and recharge it. It's like it was crazy. So, but there's
a lot to manage, yeah.
Yeah. They're roughly like 3.5 hours a piece.
Do you start all these with sketches then first, and then?
Oh no, those
just a straight.
That one was like sight unseen because I can only do so much. I've never been to that Niagara Falls, so I can only research. You know, I remember having a park. I had to walk at least like almost a quarter of a mile to get there, you know, with carrying everything.
All your stuff,
and then
yeah.
Like, where am I going to set up? Okay, I need to. Let me see if I can get these people to kindly move. Like I'm better than anyone else. So. You know, it was very, very, some of the discussions, and it's all on there, like, were very friendly,
yeah,
and some of them were candid. I'll leave it at that.
I'll have to go back and watch that one.
Yep.
Cool.
Cover your ears.
Did they know they were being videotaped?
Some of them, you know, it was like they're walking, and some of them bumped into the camera, and I had the tripod, and the iPad, it kind of tilts over, so it was this. But it's like walking, you know, Niagara Falls is like walking through Times Square or walking
right, so many
in front of the Bellagio. There's so many waves that come to and fro every like 20, 30 minutes.
Right.
So you get like 40 people.
Mm.
Well, you get like 40 people like coming through at a time. So. Yes. So. Yes, yeah, so that one's all on there. So you can watch that in its entirety. It's starting to do a little bit, not much, but starting to do something. I'm slowly adding some highlights here and there. I'm still trying to define, the drums look a little
it's not refined, so. I'm just going through, trying to define the edges, and then just adding in some of the values. But yeah, the thing with like painting live from life is like you're right there. You know, it's not a CD, it's not an MP3, it's like, mm-hmm. It's just like right there. So you're seeing everything for what it is. Painting on wood on that size is like, man, that thing would fall over and crush
it. Right,
but I mean, the black and whites, those were paper. Mm-hmm. But it's just anything at this size, that being that family portrait and afternoon diamond, that would probably be the largest. But it just feels like, you just feel assured.
Yeah, know? It's masonite, right?
It's like wearing a good belt. My pants are like falling.
Yeah.
Like, boom.
So the pressure that you put on it is like solid because you're not having to guess how far it's going to go in.
Oh, that one's like just under a month. I'm just going to double check that.
I missed it.
No worries, no worries. You're good.
Oh, I'm good. Give it to me. I've been sitting all afternoon. Did you want to say it?
Do you work on primed masonite? Is that what you're using?
Just gesso. Yeah. Just wood on canvas and then gesso.
A good feel, I know.
Yeah, I mean, otherwise it would just, you know, it would just absorb through and it wouldn't draw this color. So. I do like private instruction, like by appointment, but nothing regular. You know, so. I mean, if it's like one-on-one, if it's like a small group, if it's like in a studio, if it's like out on a mountain somewhere, you know, so. That gives you some indication of the board. And let's see. Right there.
Is that your favorite palette to use?
Yeah, I've been using this for, a while.
Did you use that palette when you did your portrait?
Yeah, for you.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. Hello, sir. You're back.
Yeah, had a little rest.
Okay. Might be some extra chairs out in the hallway. Okay, right now I'm just trying to figure out a vague indicator, a vague color for the milk crate of this two. Just throw something in there just to indicate. Now it starts to get more challenging. If it hasn't already been. And now we're basically moving down like a rough indication of color. It's taking me quite a while to get there. But now we're going to go in and refine some of the colors and refine the shape.
What are you using for?
I'm still using the original crimson, cad red, and some of the grays that have been created with the palette. There's always color and cover. There's never a red. It was never just a yellow. We'd be blind, you know. So there's always like a gray. There's color and cover. There's grays and grays. So. But yeah, I mean basically this day there's original crimson. Watching on Facebook must be like frustrated. It's like it was quiet as alive. Let's see. Did you guys fall asleep?
No.
You're still good. Did it stop or is it still warm? I guess it's still warm. Let's see. Oh, it's still going. Wait a second.
All it shows is the amount of people watching, 6 people. Schedule this to end at 7, but it's not going to end at 7. We'll go until maybe 7:30. I'll try this, a better definition of this.
Do you always work wet on wet?
Yeah, because the thing is, like, you as much as possible, you want to be immediate in the situation. You don't want to sort of
It's not like you can, well, we can't stop this conversation and then 2 weeks later pick up on the same immediacy of it. You know, we can still sort of verbalize the same words, but it'll be different. It'll never be the same. So, I mean, it's just like you want to be in that zone in the immediacy of it as much as possible, as much as you can. So, there are just things that happen more, you know, some really insane things that happen. It helps build, it helps, you know, establish like a conviction, like directness. You don't have to be like, really have to decide like, okay, am I going to go left or right, as opposed to like waiting until you fall off the cliff or waiting until the middle. You have to like decide then and there. So, and once you build up that technical skill, it's like, it's not, there's no thinking, it's like you're just reacting. So little by little, there is, you know, atmosphere, there is some shape that's starting to happen. Right now, we're just trying to get a little more shape, a little more atmosphere to the drums so that they don't look flat. So they start to curve. This is the same idea as a bass. You know, it's a shape, except there are more shapes within the shape as opposed to this. So, same approach.
eons, my dear, eons.
Did anybody else in your family paint?
My cousin did, but not representationally, but he was an artist for a while. We're both the same age, same name. He was named after his father, I was named after my uncle. We're both artists. We danced for a little while, so it's like almost two peas in a pod. But he, I don't know if he does, he went from painting, doing collage work to computer graphic work. He worked in, I think, the Museum of Chicago. I don't know how much he's involved, like, to this extent. Yeah, it's mostly instrumental. You know,
jazz or
just like instrumental, like contemporary music. Not even jazz. So I'm used to sometimes when I'm like with my family, my father likes a lot of jazz, so it's like non-descript instrumental music. So yeah, nothing more than that, otherwise, you know, I'd be like I wouldn't be able to focus. Want to go out dancing, or moving too much, or just like, you know, lose attention of what I should be doing. So. Music that's as non-confrontational as possible. if a painting, like painting or seeing something live, or you know, speaking to someone live or meeting someone live, it's like there's no better feeling. You get a sense of the authenticity of it. Even the best camera can't beat
it.
$100,000 camera. $250,000, you know, you can't duplicate what you're seeing in person. We're just figuring out how we're gonna take over there. That's awesome. I'm just working on a painting here. It's painting out of those drums right there. This is my family. Real cool people. Come around. There's a space in there. Can you see?
Yeah.
Okay. Cool. Feel free to take a card. This should be on the podium there. That's like way too crazy. Let's hope so.
Last time you checked, that was you.
Hope so.
Yeah,
that piece is titled The Game of Chess.
Did you have a hair and then you wore those clothes?
Yeah. The hat is like, you know, when I came out west, you know, I was painting outside and then like a day or two later, it's like, you know, I realized I didn't get the sunburn. So, you know, it was like, it was the first time I really like serious sunburn or whatever, just cracking the skin or dry skin or whatever. And so I got that hat. So those are all items. The bow tie, I wore performances, the blazer. The pants and shoes are long gone. I've like cut a rug like too much. I've like cut holes in those shoes for dancing. So those are some Stacey Adams. Those are like, you know, some classic Stacey Adams. I got them in a shoe shop. So. Yeah, those are some nice shoes. They've had their days somewhere. That portion, this portion of the drum is too protruding too much, so I need to. How I'm going to correct as much as possible is just basically just go over the black with, you know, as much of the tone of that gray.
Have you done very many self-portraits? Like, program, are you going to do one of yourself every couple of years?
I think as I thought about it, I've probably done like one every few years.
Yeah.
So this one was, that one was like a few years ago. So one is probably due up in maybe another, I probably don't know, maybe like 7 or 8. You know,
wow.
So maybe one in a few years or so.
Were they all like full body like that?
No, that's as close to life size as I've gotten. But I like working at that size, because you get a chance to, there's a sense of like, you know, that guy is like, almost yeah. a class size, so it's like yeah. it's a real size. So
right.
you know, it gives you it's like almost like you can sort of
walk up to it, yeah,
like,
yeah.
You
know, yeah. Like
stand next
join
to it.
Join the room, yeah.
Yeah, so but yeah, that piece is titled A Game of Chess, mm-hmm. meaning that any conversation that you have with someone, it's a give and take to engage with them. You don't want to be too far away, you don't want to be too close. You know, always sort of watching someone. It's like, so this guy's like watching. If you go from left to right, he's like watching you. Like, you gotta see you, you know, just be careful. How you doing? Mr. Sketchers? I think you can you climb walls? Climb
no.
mountains? You can't? Or you can't?
This is my sister.
That's your sister? And what's your name, sir?
Ando.
And your sister's name?
His name's Dylan.
Dylan?
Yeah. My name's Ellie.
Ellie? Okay. Dylan and Ellie. New York City. Okay, I see. Okay. So Dylan and Eddie, I'm painting those drums with you. So I'm right now I'm just trying to add a little bit more definition. Well, I always tell them that, you know, if they say, you know, we look like Lionel Hampton, they say, no, he looks like me. So, they kind of like, it, that makes them turn around really like, sad or something. Okay. So, did you two have a middle school too? My friend has two kids and it took them a while to get on the train. He was jumping for joy once they like were able to do so.
Is this like the first time that like you're a live painting and the artist is talking about the kids about potty training? We're live Facebook.
Some So doing things like this helps me stay in touch with, for many reasons, you know, for personal experiences, for business reasons, but it gives me a sense of, you know, in today's world, when we do have the advantage of technology, it's always nice to be still with tangible items and interactions. And if you look at this palette, we're pretty much working with, I'm not gonna stray too far away from anything else as far as like, you know, a green or a really stark yellow. This is pretty much the palette we're working with.
Let's see if this is still recording. It's still going. Two people.
Two people left, two people scrolling. Geographically, it's in the middle of other markets. It's close to, although it's further away from New York, it's close to larger markets like LA for different things. You know, so the museums, the type of dance that I do, it's more New York, like literally, figuratively, spiritually, mentally. So, but even the artwork that I do, it's a lot of this representational work. You're gonna see some in California, like in LA, you go to San Francisco, but a lot of it you'll see in New York, even more so if you go to Europe. So my interest is like, I actually came here, I did some stuff with Cirque du Soleil, and I worked with a few other dancers in the theater. That's what got me here. And then I thought, you know, I can always go back and forth and still build my base here. But yeah, it's probably just genes, and then we were crazy when we were kids. We used to jump off like palm trees, jump off houses. You know, it was some crazy stuff. So riding bikes down hills and hitting that pebble or skateboard, and then like shitting our legs where you see like little spots and stuff. And we would take it up and then go play somewhere else or something. We like get stung by bees and everything, but we were always outdoors. But yeah, I mean, if it's Dan, sort of, I'm painting him up, I'm moving around, you know. I can't go back too far, because you have to do it like, you know. I mean, that painting was like, was physically alive. Like, it was so much looking at me.
Did you understand? You had it in the studio?
Actually, no, I had a poke for the hat, and the other area that had a poke, you had to go up and, like, stand up and paint this. Come back down and get down. So it was like 3 steps to do 1 stroke.
Oh, man.
Get out of here, man. It was like
good capital workout.
Yeah, it was but a lot of it is a good portion of it is from ever since I've been out here, it's like when you go to different areas, it's like you can in theory you're eating the same food but it tastes different. So it's like sometimes I'll eat stuff like, man, my body doesn't feel good. So slowly I've changed my diet just because I care to an extent, but more so my body felt weird. So maybe I'm eating right for my body. I don't know. But a lot of it is from dancing, you know. So like this weekend I'll be in Phoenix, you know. So it's like, but yeah, as I was mentioning like earlier, some of my teachers. One teacher was like, you know, you have to get up, you know, get off your butts and stand up and draw and paint. That way you're more needed. You know, you're more responsive to react to something. So.
Excuse me.
Bless you.
Thank you.
Bless you. It's like you're constantly trying to make sure that you're aware of giving equal play to every part of the game. So thank you very much for staying. Thank you very much, sir. Appreciate you for showing up.
Yep.
Thank you for your time. Appreciate it. Do you need a card?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Feel free to sign the guest book. Don't leave.
I'm getting a chair.
Okay. Not every stroke is as steady as one would like for it to be, but with, you know, it's just, oh, gone. Start over again. That was the point where I was like too afraid to do that. I was like, no way in hell. Still, if it's not there, you just have to let things go.
still with us. Is anybody still there? One person.
One person's holding out. They're like, they're probably thinking there must be a prize behind this. There must be something. Watching someone paint, like, live for an hour or whatever, it's not, obviously it's not the most engaging thing, but I wanted to give people the option. I mean, they're either watching it now or they can go back and look at it later, you know, so. They can sort of get an idea of how all of these things came to be, you know, so. Thank you. you're always approaching scenarios where you're still trying to figure things out. Even with the drums and trying to get them to pop more. So it's and once again I'm using these bright colors, but it's gonna require a little more darks and grays to get things to hey. It's Bobby. Thank you. step back from it as much as I can. I'm just mapping out a plan of how we're going to take over the Pentagon. So, it requires some red, some black, and some red. Just kidding.
Your one camera here is saying it's a low battery.
I'm sorry?
It's saying low battery.
Oh, low battery. Ah, thank you.
I just had it to know.
Okay, cool. I'm at 20%. Three people. Gotta finish up this puppy.
Thank you, sir.
Sure.
Six to one to three. Someone's finished their dinner. They figured they're gonna watch. It's okay. Booger, a pink booger. As kind as we know about those. Yes. Yes, it is. It's called a pink booger. So.
Pink booger?
Yes. Little pieces of cotton wool, little pieces of this and this. Besties.
Is it a
pink booger? Yes. Stay away from us. Nightmares.
It's just, he's wrong, it's a gerbil. It's just a drum.
Yeah.
It's a gerbil.
There was a piece of thread on my brush, so, and it got in the way of the painting, so, it's called a paint booger.
Yes.
Okay.
And I made this.
Feel free to sign the book.
Okay.
Okay, we'll call it down for now. So.
Looking good.
But this gives you an idea of, you know, the process of how these pieces are brought to life. So basically, you know, you have a blank, you know, quote unquote, a canvas, and you set up your still life, and then you try and capture what's in front of you within a certain amount of time. And I wanted to give myself enough time, but not a lot of time, because that way, otherwise, you know, I'll end up relaxing. You know, I'll go get an iced tea or, you know, a salad and take a nap. You know, or so play a game or something.
Understand.
Oh,
buy it and we'll take.
Oh yes. Okay. So
really good, and I'll send it to you.
Thank you. And for those of you that I'm friends on Facebook with, whatever pictures and video you've taken. Feel free to tag.
Yep. Little closer.
Go close.
I'm trying to make sure. Okay.
You're good.
I'll make sure I get like pay on me. Okay, so.
Okay.
The bongo drums.
Okay.
So yeah, this gives you just a little indication. You kind of get the idea. You know, it's coming together. It's coming along. So, but I wanted to.
Very nice.
Thank you.
And you have to know when to stop.
Yeah. Oh yes, that's true.
Hard part that we know.
Right?
Yes.
Know when to stop. It's like I kept like struggling the past like 15 minutes. I was like fumbling, as you can see.
I know. But, no, it looks good.
Yeah.
Very good.
Okay, cool. Let me 1 second. I want to shake some hands, but I don't want to get like, you know.
Well, you stay there on the clean. I'm a mess by this one.
Sitting in the gallery painting, so I'm probably
painting. Did you paint today? Yeah.
Do you belong to a gallery?
I'm sorry?
Do you belong to a gallery?
Oh, careful, yeah, the camera.
Oh, I'm yes,
sorry. No worries, no worries. I have some work in a gallery in Little Rock, Arkansas. Hearn Fine Art.
Okay.
Yeah, Hearn Fine Art is the H-E-A-R-N-E. Fine Art, F-I-N-E-A-R-T. FineArt.com. But on WadeHampton.com, which is my site, you can see some of the work on there. So, and with this live, tonight's live painting, in conjunction with, as part of this exhibition, it was quite unique actually, because I'm not aware of too many emerging or established living or deceased artists who had basically a 9-month extensive traveling show, 3 different locations. So it doesn't happen too often. So I do want to thank the Clark County Library District for helping arrange this. So it's given me the chance to meet all of you guys. It's given me the chance to go back to Europe, go to LA, go to Arkansas, go so many places and tell people, hey, I have a show going on. So for me, it's like I'm in 2 places at once. So you're like, okay,
yeah.
I'm here, I can go out and I can, like, you know, take care of some other stuff. So, but yes, and so it's some other, with such, you know, having work on display, you know, people are coming to, are able to come see the work. I'm able to establish connections and you know, I've been able to network with new clients. So that's been pretty cool. So
that's great.
Yeah. So once again, thank all of you. Feel free to meander around. I'll be here cleaning up. Frantically trying to clean up before close at 7:32 right now. So I know they like shut the gates at like 1:45 or something.
Thank you very much. Yes.
Thank you very much.
Enjoyed it.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Amazing.
Cool. Thank you. You went to the workshop and you seemed like amazing.
Yes.
Cool.
Awesome.
Enjoy. Thank you, sir.
Great show. Appreciate it. Beautiful.
Thank you.
Did
you get a car? Okay. Cool. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Take care, sir.
Appreciate it. Appreciate it. Yes. Okay, still got power. Cool. Let me pick up a brush.
You don't mind I take some of your photos, Wade?
Sure. Just tag me.
Oh, I will, for sure. All right. Very nice.
Oh, yes, and that guy. Okay. Doing his best to stay out of trouble.
Can I take one of your parents, too?
Yes.
Is that the same as this?
Yes, it is. It has a schedule. This shows up through September 17th is the last day. It's open every day, Monday through Thursday, 10 to 8. Friday through Sunday, 10 to 6.
Can I get you next year?
Yeah.
Oops. I really should have my son for doing your photos now.
Oh, yes, true. So actually, let me get this. This will have a little more punch into it.
And the lighting is not great as well.
I'll come in somewhere?
Yeah.
Oh, over here?
She's good, but she's bad.
Okay, okay, cool.
Yeah, I'm trying to keep the from the flash bag. I mean, you got me. It's good. Okay, thank you so much, babe. Good to see you.
Thank you.
And why don't you work?
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, that was live. So I hope you enjoy the piece, the painting, the bungle drums. So even though it's live, we're cutting off live, the show will be viewable if you want to come back in tonight or later. Thank you. Adios. Muchachos.